Hey, horsey people. I left the gate open on purpose this time to let Mr. T come out here and clean up some of this grass. He's just out there munching away. I don't think he can see me through this window. There's two glass windows here. Let me move over to this area. So, see, I'm standing in the kitchen window, and because the screen is there, and the reflection off the glass, I don't think he can see me. Besides the fact that he's probably blind and can't see very good anyway. So I'm just sitting here watching him eat his little food. I'm glad he's eating that stuff right there too, because that's like a Johnson grass or some sort of grass that's kind of like, it gets really long and thick and it kind of takes over. And it pushes out my other grass, so I usually weed eat that down to the ground so it can die, but it's pretty green, and I'm glad he picked that little spot. I don't have to weed eat that, and hopefully he can eat it all down and let the other grass come through. Man, these guys, just watching them eat, I'm telling you, it's they just chew and eat 20 hours a day. I mean, can you imagine if you just locked a horse up and he just couldn't do this? He was just standing around waiting and wanting, and people wonder why their horses get ulcers and stomach ulcers. And a horse's stomach fills up with acid. It's producing acid all the time because they're used to eating all the time. And yeah, that's a pretty big body, 1,200 pounds to be eating grass. And when you put them in a stall and they can't graze and they can't eat and they don't have access to hay, that acid in the stomach just builds up. And as it builds up, you know, it eats away the lining and it does bad things. Whereas if you're always getting grass, must be little gnats or flies or something, he just stomped his foot. Again, this constant nibbling and eating, just, it's so healthy for a horse, both physically for his internals, but mentally it keeps him occupied. He's picking grass, he's smelling, he's chewing, he's taking bites, he's mentally stimulated, although he's still looking around for threats. He's looking for things to run from. He's looking for dangers. And I don't know where Buddy's at. He's probably over there eating one of my damn trees. I'm going to have to go find him. Damn Hollywood Dennis the Menace always getting into something. He can't be a good boy like old Mr. T. Poor old Mr. T. Clean up all that grass. There you go. Get around that mat there. Then I'll have to weed eat that. Good boy, Mr. T. Good boy, old Mr. T. I don't know if he hears me or not. I'm going to talk a little louder. Good boy, Mr. T! Mr. T! Tanner! Big T! You can't hear me. If I yell at Buddy, you'll hear that. Buddy, you better... Horse got me in trouble. I was eating and enjoying myself. Poor Mr. T. Dad's mean to him. Let me try to move up here where there's no screen. Maybe you can get a better picture. Alright, well, I know some of you like to watch him eat. I was just standing here drinking my coffee, kind of like watching him snack and chew, and it's just soothing and relaxing to watch him. He looks smaller when I'm filming up top. If I move down, he looks like he got bigger. Filming 101. If you aim from the top, you'll look smaller. That's why everybody takes their damn selfies with the phone way in the air looking down. Somehow they think they're fooling everybody.
Rick, why are you picking out people who take selfies?
Shut up! I'm not picking on anybody, I'm just stating a fact. Alright, well, in that there, watching old Mr. T eat. He's a good old boy. Mr. T, you're a good boy! Whatever, dude, shut up. Unless you yell at Buddy, I don't care. There's that damn Buddy. I gotta go find him before he tears up the whole damn house and shit.